You know, I don't ever like putting words in anybody's mouths. You know, one, that's definitely a legal issue we don't want to get involved in, and I certainly don't want to do it to Chris Christie. But based on the comments that Chris Christie has made following the FBI going down to Mar-a-Lago, it really seems to me like Chris Christie wants Donald Trump to go to jail. And that really shouldn't surprise anybody, right? But here is what Chris Christie had to say. By the way, former federal prosecutor. So this guy's opinion carries a good amount of weight here, no pun intended. Here's what Chris Christie said following the raid. It's fair game, and you just have to display probable cause to a federal judge that there are contents that you have reasonably, there are contents in that safe that would assist in proving a violation of the law. It's not anything that's out of bounds to go into a safe, and it happens frequently in federal law enforcement. But again, you have to have the factual underpinnings to be able to convince a federal judge that you need and have the right to do that. This is not something that you should be doing willy-nilly. This is something that should be backed up by grave concerns about the conduct of the subject of the search warrant. I hope that more information comes sooner rather than later, because the longer you let this sit out there, the more speculation will generate, and that's not good for anybody. So let's break down what Christie is saying here, right? He's telling us, first and foremost, unlike what all the other Republicans are saying, is that no, they can totally do this. Doesn't matter that he's a former president. It's 100% legal, so shut the hell up. Number two, he is telling them, he's not telling us, he's telling these Republicans out there trying to act like this is all a big setup. He's telling them, they clearly had evidence, right? They had probable cause. They had evidence of probable cause. And it was great enough that a judge signed off and said, all right then, yeah, you can absolutely go search the residence of the former president of the United States based on what you have presented to me. So Chris Christie is really trying to tell these people, they've got evidence. They definitely think that he committed a crime, and they think they can prove it with what is being held in Mar-a-Lago. And again, as far as we know, they left with at least 12 boxes of things. Things that, by the way, were not planted by the FBI, as most Republicans are trying to claim now. But again, Chris Christie really seems to want Donald Trump to be guilty. And look, I'm right there with you, Chris, but obviously for different reasons. See, Chris Christie not only has a personal axe to grind against Donald Trump for not bringing him into the administration, but Chris Christie also desperately wants to be the president of the United States. He's made his trips. He's gone to those early primary states. He's spent a hell of a lot of time in New Hampshire. He's been to Iowa. He's attended the events that are typically only attended by people who are going to be running for president. Chris Christie wants Trump out of the picture because he thinks he can swoop in, say that, hey, I'm not a crazy Republican, and everybody's going to forget about how corrupt he was when he was governor of New Jersey. And to be honest, like all that horrible corruption that took place under Chris Christie's administration in New Jersey, like that's nothing compared to what we've seen from Trump. So in, you know, by comparing the two, sure, it seems Christie's normal, but no, he is a super corrupt guy. Very, very corrupt. But that's how far we've come in just like 6 years, folks. Chris Christie's, you know, actions as governor 6 years ago basically made him get laughed off stage. But today it's like, oh, well, that's not so bad. It's not so bad that he shut down bridges to hurt his political enemies. It's not so bad that he shut down an entire beach so that he could use it for his family. No, those are things that absolutely were a political death sentence a decade ago. And today it's like, nah, politics as usual. And that's what Chris Christie is banking on. But the only way he can get to that point is if Donald Trump somehow gets tossed out of the race. And Chris Christie is hoping, very clearly based on what I see in his comments here, that this investigation does that for him.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.